A very good morning to you all students. This is the first revision module of economics, chapter 2, basic concepts of economics. Now you are free from all the miseries and all the uncertainties regarding class 10 examinations. Okay, so now it's time for you all to start concentrating on class 11 syllabus. Okay, so the first chapter we'll be dealing today is basic concepts of economics. This is the revision module 1. Meaning of human wants. What do you mean by a want? A want is an effective desire. Okay, a person has a desire to have a commodity. Okay, so a want is an effective desire. I may have a desire to buy a car. But if I am not earning, that will not become want. Okay. So for any desire, desire is simply a wish. I wish to have a car. Okay. It will become a want when I'll make an effort to have a car. Okay. So in this case, the desire to have a car will become a want when I am earning money to buy that car. Okay, so a want is an effective desire and it will only be valid when a person makes an effort to actually fulfill something. Okay, got it? Now, the various classification of human wants is given. Human wants are of two categories, primary wants and secondary want. Primary wants are the necessities of life and secondary wants are further divided into comforts and luxury. Okay, primary wants are the wants that are necessary for living a life. Okay, what are the three things that are required to live a life? Roti, kapda, makan. Food, clothing, shelter. These three things are required in life to maintain a normal efficiency. Okay, if you eat something in the morning in the breakfast, you will need something in the lunch as well. So food is something that helps you to maintain your normal efficiency and also to live a happy life. So primary wants are the wants of necessities that are food, shelter and clothing. Coming to the secondary wants. Secondary wants can only be fulfilled after the primary wants are fulfilled. Okay, the secondary wants comes after the primary wants of food, shelter and clothing are filled. Okay, so secondary wants are the wants of comfort and the wants for luxury. Now, when I talk about comfort, comfort is something that gives you happiness, okay, a feeling of fulfillment. So, examples like music system in your house, okay, sofa set, cooler in your bedroom. All these are examples of comfort. Okay, something that gives you happiness in your life. And when we talk about the luxury items are the items which are known about to show your wealth and power. Okay, suppose someone is living in a modern house or they are driving a good Mercedes or some luxurious car. So luxury is not for happiness of us, but it is for showing our wealth and power to others. So basically human wants are of two categories, primary wants and secondary want. Primary want is the want of necessity and secondary wants are further divided into comfort and luxury. Comfort is for our own happiness and luxury is to demonstrate our power and wealth to others. The next definition is consumption. The act of using goods and services to satisfy human wants is called consumption. You feel hungry, you eat an apple. What are you doing? You are consuming apple to satisfy your hunger. Okay. In the same manner, if you feel thirsty, you either drink water or you substitute it for some kind of juice. Okay, so again, what are you doing? You are satisfying your thirst with the help of a drink, water or a juice. So the act of using the goods and services to satisfy human wants is called consumption. The sustainable consumption concept means thinking about the future. Consuming in such a manner that you also think about the future generations. Okay? The key words in the definition of sustainable consumption are the act of using goods and services in such a manner that it meets the needs of people and improves the quality of life of people, and it does not have any adverse or bad effect on the environment and the needs of future generation. Okay, so what do we mean by sustainable consumption? It is the act of using goods and services wherein you are satisfying the needs of the people, but you are not harming the environment. And we know that water and other resources are, you know, it is becoming scarce. So we need to think about the future generations as well. Okay, we should utilize the resources, consume them in such a manner that we also leave something for the generations to come. And the consumption must improve the quality of life as well. The next topic is utility and the features of utility. When we want to define utility, the definition is very easy. Utility is the want satisfying power of a commodity. Okay, example, the power of a glass of water that it satisfies the thirst. Okay, you won't feel thirsty anymore. Same way, the utility of a chapati is when you have the chapati, you'll not feel hungry anymore. Okay, so utility is the want satisfying power of a commodity. It is the ability or capacity of a commodity to fulfill any want. Okay, it may be any kind of want. Coming to the features of utility, there are 6 features of utility over here. First one is utility is subjective. Subjective meaning it is depending on an individual's own estimate. Okay, there are 2 people, Ram and Shyam. Okay, when both of them go out, Ram eats 4 burgers and Shyam eats 7 burgers. Okay, so for Ram, 4 burgers are enough. He is happy. But for Shyam, 7 burgers are also not enough. Okay, so he's not happy. So it is subjective. Okay, the hunger of Shyam is more and the diet of Ram is less. So we say that utility is subjective. It depends on an individual's own subjective estimate. Second point is utility is not measurable. See, any quantity to be measurable must be objective and not subjective. Just now we discussed that utility is subjective. Okay, it is not common. It depends from person to person. So how can we say that utility is measurable? Since it is subjective, utility cannot be measured by any measuring rod. Okay, the third point is utility is relative in nature. Utility is relative in nature means it changes from time to time, place to place. Okay, the utility of woolen clothes is only in winters, right? And the utility of air conditioners or coolers are only in summers. So from time to time, things have different utility. The hot drinks that you have are useful or giving you utility in the winters. Okay, the woolen clothes give you utility in the winters, not in the summers. Same manner, utility also depends from person to person. Okay, a person in a situation where a person is not very hungry, a chapati will give him less utility. But a person who hasn't eaten from the whole day, for that person, that one chapati will have maximum utility. Okay, so a person who is not that hungry, for that person one chapati does not matter, it will not give much utility. But for a person who hasn't eaten anything from the morning, for that person one chapati means a lot. It is giving him maximum satisfaction. The next point is utility is abstract. Utility is a feeling. Okay, it's a feeling of satisfaction. And it cannot be seen or touched. It can only be felt. So utility is abstract, cannot be seen or touched. It can only be felt. Utility is different from usefulness. Often we confuse the two topics, utility and usefulness. Okay, utility and usefulness are two separate things. A thing will have a utility for that person, but it may be not that useful, okay, or it may be harmful to that person. For a drinker, the alcohol or the liquor is, you know, very harmful for the health. But a drinker who has the habit of drinking alcohol, for that person, that alcohol will give him very much maximum utility. But it is not useful for him. So we cannot say that whichever commodity has utility is also useful. Okay. So we take the example of a drinks alcohol. It is harmful for his health, but still it gives him satisfaction or utility. Utility has no moral or legal connotations. The word utility is neutral between good and bad. It is neutral between ethical, non-ethical. Okay, so it does not have any moral or legal connotation. It is neutral. It doesn't say anything about them. Okay, for example, carrying a gun is not legal. Okay, but for a dacoit who is, you know, looting the houses, for that person, a gun has maximum utility. Right? A gun will have utility for a dacoit, but it is not legal to carry a gun. Okay, so utility is not having any moral or legal connotations. Thank you, students, for watching the video. Moreover, you know, you have to start taking the video seriously, start studying seriously, because there will be assessments for whatever has been taught till now. So yes, you have to study. These are tough times, difficult times. Digital learning is, you know, bit new to you. But as we are adopting new methods of teaching, we are trying our best. We want you also to adopt this method of learning. Thank you, students. Have a nice day and stay safe.